Aripiprazole, an atypical antipsychotic with unique mechanism of action. Antipsychotics can be classified into two categories. The first one, they can be classified as a typical as well as atypical agents. So typical agents are the old generation antipsychotics and atypical agents are the new generation antipsychotics. Particularly, atypical antipsychotics have less risk of extrapyramidal side effects. So aripiprazole is such type of a drug which belongs to the atypical category. What is actually aripiprazole and what is its structure? If we see the structure of aripiprazole, it is a very large structure with different chains, and among these we can observe dihydroquinoline 2-one as one of the ring system present in the aripiprazole. Of course, it is also having another heterocyclic ring like the piperazine, but dihydroquinoline 2-one is one of the important ring system present in the aripiprazole. How it acts? Aripiprazole is unique in its action such that it acts as a partial agonist on the dopamine receptors. Thereby, it has having less extrapyramidal side effects. So that's why it is categorized as atypical antipsychotic. Aripiprazole can act as antagonist on the mesolimbic pathway where the dopamine levels are excessively increased. At the same time, it can also act as agonist on the nigrostatal pathway where the dopamine levels are decreased. So the increased dopamine levels in the mesolimbic pathway are responsible for the psychosis, and the decreased dopamine levels in the nigrostatal pathway is responsible for the motor disturbances like the extrapyramidal side effects. Now, as aripiprazole is going to act as an antagonist on this mesolimbic pathway, it produces an antipsychotic action, and it acts as an agonist on the nigrostatal pathway, thereby it increases the dopamine action, resulting in the less extrapyramidal side effects. So in this way, aripiprazole is having a unique action such that it acts as both antagonist as well as agonist with less extrapyramidal side effects. What are the side effects of the aripiprazole? Even it is having the less EPS, it can produce the other set of side effects which can be classified into different types. First one, it can produce headache, lightheadedness and dizziness. So this lightheadedness may cause risk of falling in the patients. And other set of side effects include salivation, constipation, blurred vision, nausea and vomiting, and allergic reactions. Of course, all these side effects are common in most of the patients treated with the aripiprazole. Other side effects include mainly the weight gain. So whenever patients are treated with the aripiprazole, there is a chance of weight gain in the patients. It is a common side effect shown by many of the atypical antipsychotics. Aripiprazole can also cause few of the side effects like raised body temperature, muscle rigidity, mental retardation and tachycardia. So these side effects are commonly known as neuroleptic malignant syndrome observed with other drugs like chlorpromazine. In such situation, the body temperature is abnormally raised with some muscle rigidity and mental retardation. This neuroleptic malignant syndrome can be treated by few of the drugs like dantrolene, which blocks the calcium release from the sarcoplasmic reticulum, thereby prevents the muscle rigidity and raise in the body temperature. Clinical uses. One of the important clinical use of the aripiprazole is in the treatment of the psychosis. So aripiprazole can relieve both positive as well as the negative symptoms. That's why it is one of the drug which is widely preferred in the treatment of the psychosis. Second important clinical use, the bipolar depression. In the bipolar depression, the mood of the patient swings from the mania to the depression. In such case, aripiprazole is effective in treatment of the bipolar depression. Other clinical uses. Aripiprazole can also be used in the Tourette syndrome, which includes the involuntary movements as well as production of the unusual voice. So these involuntary movements can disturb the vocal cords, which produce some unusual voice. In such case, again, the aripiprazole is used to block these involuntary movements. And another one is the autism. This includes the reduced social interaction and social communication, particularly observed in the children. So in such case, again, the aripiprazole is approved to treat the autism in the children. So these are the various clinical use of the aripiprazole. So aripiprazole is one of a drug with a unique mechanism acting like a partial agonist. So it acts as an antagonist on one receptor as well as agonist on another receptor. And it has less extrapyramidal side effects, and it can be used in the various clinical conditions like the bipolar depressive disorder, Tourette syndrome, as well as autism.